want to remove every screw, pull out all these little rubber things. Underneath most of them will be a screw. You want to save them because you're going to want to put them back on. I don't think there's any under those two, so you don't need to remove these two. So yeah, one here, one here. And then up top, I guess they put them on all of them up top. But it don't look like there's one here or one there. So just remove the screws now. This is how you do it when you don't want to take the whole screen assembly off. This makes it a lot quicker and a lot easier to change the LCD. A lot of people take the whole screen assembly off of the laptop and it just takes forever. This is quick and to the point. Once you do that, you want to get this bezel started. You can start bottom or sides, it don't matter. Just get your fingers under it and just gently pull it up. There's glue, a little glue on it. See this? You don't need that on there. If it starts coming off, just pull it off. It'll go back on with the screws alone. Just try and get it off without breaking it. Alright, I'm going to try and make this as easy as possible. Instead of pulling it off, taking out unnecessary screws, if you get another screwdriver and you just pull this thing up, you kind of hold it up. Let me get it to where you can see it. If you position this screwdriver under here, right? And you could get this screw out. Take this one out first. All right, she's loose. So that screws out. If you get these four screws out and you do the same thing on the other side, then this LCD will lift right up. It's kind of hard hold my hands like this without blocking the camera. But if you take these four out, this saves you so much time and so much energy from just taking that whole screen assembly off. That side's loose, you're gonna spin it around and do the same thing over on this other side. Try and get it to where you can see it better. But let's see. Sorry about that. If you lift up here, like I said, you can get that. These bottom ones are gonna be the hardest ones to get out and get back in. So let's move that so you can see it. Once that one's out, once they're back in, it's super easy. It's really hard to do it one hand so the camera can see. Can't get the pressure you need behind it, but we'll get it. This is the last one here. Once you have that done, this LCD, it just lifts up. You can unplug it, plug a new one right in. I'm gonna change the camera angle so you can see what I'm doing. All right, so you have it loose. You want to lift it up. I'm gonna pull it closer to you so you can see this tape. You need to peel this tape off. You can't really. Trying to find a way to show you where you can see it, but just peel the tape back. Really strong tape on mine. And then you want to peel it back. Once you do that, be careful when you get to this part, because if you peel it back too far, it'll rip this cable. Then you want to, let me change the camera for you. I'll just hold it in my hand. It's a bunch of tape, but once you get this loose, you take this LCD off, you get you a new one, you can lay it down there like that. Alright, you got it like that, you want to shove that back on. Once you do, tape that, then get your scotch tape. You can get a new piece of tape. It's just scotch tape. Once you do that, once you got that plugged back in, you just flip it back. Lay it back in there. And then you put your screws back in the sides. Now the first one's going to be hard to start, but this saved you, you know, such a great amount of time. It's not a problem. So, I mean, you don't have to start the bottom one if you don't want to. I usually try and get that one first. Just prop it back up. And then if you push down right here, it kind of teeter-totters it back into place. I'll try and show you without blocking the camera if I can. So teeter-totter it. Alright, I'm way off.
Monster.
All right, so you want to teeter-totter it. Just push it. There you go. You get used to it, it becomes a lot easier. The next one you want to do would be this top one right here. It's hard not having a camera, man, to help you out. Trying to show somebody. Once you do so many of these, you can do them with your eyes closed, pretty much. Put this last one in, and I'll switch you around to the other side. teeter-totter this side too. Get your screw ready. Kind of look at that hole, line it up. Sorry, I kind of got out of the camera view for a second. Put that one in next. Uh-oh. Don't be scared to press hard on this bezel to get it to snap into place. Once that bezel's on, you want to go around and put all your screws back in.
No.
Now, there ain't too many screens you can't fix this way. Just buy your LCD and then pop it off like that. If there's any goop on top of them screws, leave that goop on there. That way them little rubber things go back on there. Go back on the screws and stay. Now if you don't have anything for them to stick to, you could find little types of Elmer's glue. There's this purple kind of Elmer's glue, like a glue stick. It's real sticky like that. You can just pull a little chunk off and roll it in your hand, roll it in your fingers and put it on there, and it'll stick them little rubber things to it. Once all your screws are in, you just go and replace your little rubber things. I don't know what they call them. I call them nipples. Replace your rubber nipples. Once that's done, you're good to go. Your screen's fixed. It'll work like new.